Joining us tonight, retired Army Colonel Douglas McGregor. Doug, great to have you with us. We appreciate it. And let's start with China and Russia, because that seems to be the biggest development that I can see on the horizon. The two coming together for military exercises that are of a huge, huge order of magnitude. Your thoughts on this?
Well, I think we have to see Iran and Russia as limited liability partners. This is by no means a permanent alliance. And in the case of Iran, and this is what we're talking about right now, the potential for exercises involving the Iranians, I think the pressure is being exerted from Tehran on Moscow and Beijing to show some measure of solidarity with them, because Iran is in a lot of trouble. The government is on very shaky ground, and they're hoping that this will prop them up somewhat. But beyond that, the Russians and the Iranians don't, the Russians and the Chinese don't share the same interest in Iran. The Chinese are interested in using Iran as a terminal for the One Belt, One Road project, and also because of their dependence on oil and gas. But Russia's interest is really far more limited. They're grateful to the Iranians for help in Syria against the Turks.
Let's turn to Soros and Koch, an incredible alliance, but seeming to announce that they're going to put up this institute to think about, strategize about what the President of the United States is already doing. That is, working to bring our troops home, to create a modest foreign policy more in order and commensurate with this nation's history and traditions.
Well, Lou, even a broken clock is right twice a day. So let's give credit to Soros and his partner in crime, Mr. Koch, for being right for a change on something. It's a little late. President Trump has got us on that glide path. We're headed in the right direction. The problem is that Mr. Soros in particular has funded or helped fund these massive migrations out of Central America. Both of them support open borders. Mr. Soros helps to fund Antifa here inside the United States. These two men are effectively sharing responsibility for the massive criminality pouring into the United States from Mexico and the war in Mexico that no one wants to talk about.
Colonel, we appreciate you being with us as always. Colonel Doug McGregor.